In some parts of Nairobi, like Eastleigh, residents have surrendered to the current movement restrictions. Eastleigh residents will have to stay within the neighborhood for a couple more days as government seeks to stop the spread of the new coronavirus. But in other parts of the city, people are easing back into normalcy. This weekend, the second installment of a 21-day night curfew and restricted movement in and out of Nairobi is coming to an end. At Witemere Market in Parklands, traders, who are among the most affected by the restrictions due to the movement of produce, have mixed feelings about possible reopening of the city.
At least ingekuwa better.
Mimi nasema waongezeke kwa sababu wakirudi tu hapa tu watu watagojeka. Tungangane tu hivyo tu.
Hata kama atazidi kuongezea siku kadhaa. Lakini atufungulie njia za biashara. Mizigo zimekwama.
It's a sensitive decision for government. The push and pull between the health of the economy and the health of the nation.
What you already know about the economic consequences of this virus?
Economist Joy Kiiru thinks it's time to think about salvaging the economy from further damage.
Of course, there's massive pileup of debt, both the public and in the private sector. Debts are piling up, and we know the consequences of that. If we continue now, the next step and where we really should try to avoid is the stock market. The moment we proceed from where we are, the stock market will be affected, and should we continue, it could crash.
A recent report by the Ministry of Labor revealed that 1.2 million jobs have so far been lost since the beginning of this pandemic.
Which are those parts of the economies or those industries that you feel should be opened up sooner?
We can start by the higher education sector, starting with the topmost degrees, just to test. To talk about PhD students and graduate students, there are fewer, isn't it? Clearly, there we know that social distancing can work for that.
All these are scenarios that the president and his team are possibly weighing before announcing the way forward over the weekend. The United States of America is discussing reopening their economy, and the Center for Disease Control has issued guidelines on how businesses, schools, and other spaces can ease back into business. But as lessons from other countries show, easing restrictions prematurely and without a plan could be a matter of life and death. Asha Mwilu, Citizen TV, Nairobi.